In this lecture, we will talk about approach to a patient with breathlessness in a general practitioner's clinic. First, we will consider a patient who has mild breathlessness. When you see a breathless patient, the first thing that comes to your mind is whether it is asthma. Is there wheezing? Are ronchi heard on auscultation? Ask specifically whether there is wheezing at night or in the early morning. If there is no wheezing, no ronchi, then we think of three possibilities. One, it is a parenchymal lung disease. Two, it could be a heart disease. And three, it could be a systemic problem like severe anemia or metabolic disorder like diabetic ketoacidosis. Accordingly, first see his tongue, conjunctiva and palms for severe pallor. Anemia has to be quite severe to cause breathlessness. Then ask about cough, chest pain and fever for lung disease. And auscultate the chest carefully for crepitations, reduced air entry, ronchi, bronchial breathing or heart murmurs. Then you should look for edema on the legs. This should be a reflex. When a patient complains of breathlessness, reflexly you should look at the legs for edema. Leg edema with breathlessness suggests congestive cardiac failure. So if the edema be present, look for distended neck veins. Then palpate for a tender, soft liver and auscultate for a heart murmur. These are signs of CCF. Now we will consider the primary treatment by the general practitioner in various clinical situations. Remember, we are discussing mild degree breathlessness. In the first situation, if the patient has expiratory ronchi, then it is a case of bronchial asthma. Only in elderly patients, if the chest is barrel-shaped, we think of emphysema. In a patient with ronchi, first give a tablet of deriphyline or acetylene or a combination like thioacetylene. In young patients, oral acetylene is more effective, but some patients may get hand tremors after taking acetylene. For them, you should give thiophylline. For immediate relief, give injection deriphyline 2 cc IM and 2 puffs of acetylene inhaler. I advise you to keep a acetylene inhaler and a spacer in the clinic so that the spacer can be washed and reused and it can be used in children and severely breathless patients who cannot use MDI inhaler. If the ronchi are significantly more and the patient is visibly breathless, give injection deriphyline 2 cc IM. A more severe attack would need intravenous aminophylline injection. A good practitioner would also keep a nebulizer in his clinic and immediate nebulization with acetylene or duolin will relieve the dyspnea within a few minutes. If the patient is a known asthmatic who will require medicines often and over prolonged periods, do not prescribe oral drugs but advise inhaled drugs, either MDI inhalers or rotacaps. Use acetylene, that is salbutamol, or salmeterol or ipratropium inhaler for immediate relief. And for long-term prevention of asthma, prescribe steroid inhalers like beclomethasone or budesonide. Now we will consider a patient who has mild breathlessness with edema over the legs. If the neck veins are distended, or liver is tender and palpable, or a murmur is heard over the precordium, or there is tachycardia, then it is a case of congestive cardiac failure or CCF. Give a tablet of Lasix Stat and digitize the patient by starting tablenoxin 1 TDS for 3 days, followed by 1 OD 6 days a week. For breathlessness, give injection deriphyline 2 cc IM, followed by tab deriphyline TDS. If dyspnea is severe, give injection aminophylline 250 mg slow intravenously and Lasix 1 ampule intravenously stat. After the initial treatment, this patient should be referred to a physician or a cardiologist for further investigations and treatment. Now we come back to another patient with mild breathlessness and leg edema. A severely anemic patient may also have generalized edema, but there are no signs of CCF, that is, no distension of neck veins, no hepatomegaly or heart murmurs apart from the flow murmur. If conjunctiva and tongue are very pale, consider anemia as the cause for edema and breathlessness. Give tab-derifilin for dyspnea, tab-Lasix-OD for edema and hematinix, and get hemoglobin done. If anemia is so severe as to cause edema and breathlessness, it will usually need a blood transfusion. An immediate blood transfusion or red cell transfusion should be followed by oral and injectable iron. Next, we have a patient with breathlessness who has fever, cough and chest pain. Symptoms of lung disease. If there is unilateral pain on breathing in with mild to moderate fever and cough, then think of pleurisy. Auscultate carefully, especially laterally in the infraaxillary region. Harsh, rough, rubbing sounds of pleural rub are heard in dry pleurisy, while in pleural effusion, breath sounds are absent. If there is high fever and patient is looking toxic with tachycardia, think of pneumonia. Low-grade fever, cough with expectoration, cavity breath sounds suggest pulmonary tuberculosis. Basically, we should, on clinical examination, identify that there is a lung or pleural infection, then give the primary treatment and ask for investigations, that is, X-ray of the chest, hemoglobin, WBC count and ESR. The primary treatment will be injection derifilin 2cc IM and tab derifilin TDS for breathlessness, tab paracetamol for fever, antitussive like lignitascodine for cough, and an antibiotic, a quinolone like ofloxacin or levofloxacin, and if the infection is severe, then third generation cephalosporin. After investigations, the final treatment will be decided, and if need be, the patient is referred to a physician. Till now, we discussed cases with mild degree of breathlessness. If breathlessness is severe, the approach will be on similar lines, but the initial treatment will have to be more aggressive. First of all, start oxygen by nasal mask or catheter. Don't say you don't have an oxygen cylinder in your clinic. You should have one, and you should check it every week to keep it in good working condition. So start oxygen, give injection derifilin 2cc intramuscular or IV stat. If the patient has bronchi or bronchial asthma, give 2 puffs of asthaline inhaler followed by asthaline or duolin nebulization. If the patient has not responded to derifilin injection and asthaline inhalation, then give injection aminophylline 10 ml diluted with 10 ml of 25% glucose slowly intravenously with injection Decadron 2cc IV. Aminophylline can be repeated after 10 minutes if necessary. If still there is no response, then refer the patient immediately to a nearby hospital or physician. Now, if the patient has no wheezing, it may be a cardiac asthma with either LVF or CCF, that is left ventricular failure or congestive cardiac failure. In LVF, the pulse will be very feeble, fine crepitations are heard all over the chest, and there is history of chest pain of myocardial infarction. This patient should be rushed to the hospital. In the meanwhile, give aminophylline, intramuscular Lasix, sublingual sorbitrate 10 mg and 1 tablet of dysprin. Note that we give Lasix intramuscularly and not IV when the blood pressure is low. IV Lasix causes further hypotension. Rush this patient to a hospital. In CCF, there are signs of right heart failure, that is distended neck veins, tender liver, edema and murmur. We have already discussed this. But if the dyspnea is severe, give intravenous aminophylline and Lasix 1 to 2 ampules IV. Give tab Lanoxin 3 stat, then 1 TDS. Tab Compose or tab Restil 0.25 mg stat. Oxygen and propped up position. That is the treatment of congestive cardiac failure. Now, if there are only lung signs, crepitations, bronchial breathing or diminished breath sounds, then give injection aminophylline, injection Decadron, a higher antibiotic, start oxygen and then send him for investigations. Lastly, let me tell you one very important point to remember. The patient has breathlessness, but there are neither any lung signs nor heart signs. X-ray chest is normal, that is breathlessness without any visible lung or heart pathology. Then before thinking of hysteria, think of metabolic problems, usually either diabetic ketoacidosis or renal failure with acidosis. So if the X-ray chest is normal, investigations for dyspnea should include blood sugar, ketone bodies, blood urea and serum creatinine. Lastly, hysteria. If the patient, especially a female, is behaving abnormal, seeking attention, making sounds and noise, then it may be hysterical. If you have seen hysterical patients before, you will identify it quickly. Yet, you will have to rule out other causes of breathlessness first and only then think of hysteria.